Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another tutorial. I hope you guys are doing good. And let's have a look on what we are going to create today. So we are going to create this awesome profile card design using HTML and CSS. I had tried to explain every single step, so make sure to watch this tutorial completely. Also, I will must recommend you guys to check out my other tutorials. I had posted many awesome tutorials related to HTML, CSS and JavaScript. And I regularly upload this kind of amazing tutorials, so make sure you are subscribed to this channel. Now, before moving on to the tutorial, let me tell you guys that this YouTube channel is in collaboration with Newton School. You can check out their website, the link is in description. And also, let's understand a bit about what exactly is Newton School. Let's see about what is Newton School. So Newton School is a platform which prepares you for your career in tech. It has courses designed for working professionals, freshers, and even people with no tech background. That means even if you are from a non-tech background, you can also join this platform and can make your career in tech. Newton School will first train you for 6 months and will help you become an amazing full stack developer. Now you might be thinking whether this platform is free or not. So let me tell you a cool thing, that you don't have to pay Newton School anything until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. I repeat guys, you don't have to pay Newton School anything for the 6 months full stack developer training until and unless you are pledged with a minimum 5 lakh CTC. And I think this is something that all of us should expect from any training program. So must check out their website for more information. I will provide the link in description. Now on their website, you can see they have something called the Launchpad. So Launchpad is basically an initiative taken by Newton School for people who want to start their coding journey from scratch, and that too absolutely free of cost. This video of mine will be also available on the Launchpad section. You can go there anytime and you can learn basics of programming languages, you can practice quizzes, and even you can do assignments. These all things are completely free to do. Now let's start creating our profile card. So I had opened the output here. Now let's start writing the markup for this card. First of all, I will create an element for our card. So I will use div tag and I will give it a class of card. And now inside the card, what I want is basically, I will divide the card into two parts. The very first part will be this card header, which will contain this image. And the second part will be the card body, which will contain the rest of the elements. Okay. So let's quickly create those elements. I will create the card header first. So I will use div tag for that and I will give it a class of card header. Inside the card header, as we saw, we need an image. So I will use the img tag and I do have the source link of that image. So let me copy and paste it. And also let's write an alt text. So let's say profile picture for now. And let me close the image tag. So we have included our image. You can see that we have included our image. Now let's create the card body. Okay, so I will again use div tag for that and I will give it a class of card body. And inside card body, you can see the very first element that we need is the name. Okay, so I will use h2 tag for that. So I will write h2 and I will copy and paste the name. And after that, we need an username. Okay, so I will use p tag for that and I will give it a class of username. And let me copy and paste the username. Now we need some social media links. Okay, so I will create a container for all of our social media links. So I will use div tag and I will give it a class of social media list. And I will include the social media links here. Okay, so since they are linked, I will use anchor tag. And currently I'm not giving any link, but you can include your profile links if you want. Okay, and we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we need 5 social media links. So let me copy and paste this. Now we have to include the icons of our social media platform inside this link. Okay, so I will use font or some icons. So let me first import the font or some CDN. So I will open CDN.js in my new tab. I will search for font awesome. I will open the font awesome and I will copy the link tag and I will paste it inside my head tag. So we have included the font awesome CDN. Now we can use font awesome icons. So let me open the fontawesome.com in new tab. We need the Facebook icon first. So I will search for Facebook. And we need this icon, so I will open it and I will copy the HTML part and I will paste it inside our anchor tag. Okay, and you can see we got our Facebook icon. So you can see we got our Facebook icon, and I will include the other social media icons in the same way. So I am fast forwarding the video. So I have included all the social media icons inside our anchor tags. Okay, so you can see we got all the social media icons, and now let's see what else do we need in our card body. Okay, so you can see after social media icons we need an about text. So let me create that. I will use p tag for that and I will give it a class of about. And let me copy and paste the about text from here. And at last we need a button for message. Okay, so I will use anchor tag again since we want a link button. So I will give it a class of btn and I will write message inside it. So we are done with our markup. You can see we have included all the elements that we need for our card. Now let's start styling our card using CSS. I will start with a basic reset. So I will use universal selector to target all the elements, and I want to give them margin 0, padding 0 and box sizing of border box. Now I will style our body tag. So first of all, I will give it a background color of 61A1DD, and also I want to center my card within our body. So we will use the flex method to center our card. So first of all, let me give height of 100VH to our body tag and display flex to our body tag. Now I will give justify content center to align our card horizontally center, and align items center to align our card vertically center. Okay, now also before moving on any else design, let's first give a width and height to our image since it's too big. So first of all, I will give width and height to our image. So I will target the image inside card header and I will give it a width of 120 pixel and the height of 120 pixel. You can see we got width and height, and now let's also give object fit cover so that our image keeps it aspect ratio. Okay, so you can see our image is now looking nice, and we want the image to be in circular shape. So I will give border radius of 50% to our image, and now let's start styling our card. So I will target the card element. And first of all, I will give it a background color of white, and I want that the width of our card element should not exceed 320 pixels. So I will give maximum width to our card. So I will use the max width property and I will give 320 pixel to max width. Now let's move on to card header. So I will target card header. And let me first give it a border so that you can see the card header properly. So I will give it a border of 2 pixels solid and red in color. So you can see this is our card header. So first of all, we want some padding inside it. So I will give it a padding. and I want the padding to be 35 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. Now we want to center our image. So what I will do is basically I will give text align center to the image parent, that is card header. Okay, so I will give text align center to card header, and now you can see our image is in center. Let's also give a linear gradient background to our card header. So linear gradient is basically considered as background image. So I will use the background image property to give our card header a linear gradient background. And now I will write the linear gradient function, and I want the first color to be 61A1DD, and I want the second color to be 0083FD, and also I want the direction of our linear gradient to be 60 degree. And now you can see we got our linear gradient in card header. Now before moving on to card body, let's first give our image a box shadow. So I will write box shadow property here, and I want the X offset to be 0, I want the Y offset to be 10 pixel, I want the blur value to be 30 pixel, and for the color I will use the RGBA format, and I will pass the RGB value of black color, that is 0, 0 and 0, and for the alpha value I will pass 0.2 just to get a softer box shadow. Okay, so you can see we got a soft box shadow on our image. Let's also remove the border from our card header, and that's it, we are done with our card header. Now let's move on to card body. Okay, so again in card body we want some spacing, so I will use padding, and this time I want 35 pixel padding from all these sides. So we got some spacing from all the sides in card body, and I want to give the color of hashtag 565656 to all of my card body elements. So I have given the color, and now before continuing styling our card body, let's first import the Poppins font from Google Fonts, since we want the Poppins font in all of our elements. So I will open Google Fonts in new tab. We want the Poppins font, so I will open it, and we have already selected the font weights, so we want semi bold and light. Okay, so I had already selected them. So let me copy and paste the link tag, and I will paste it inside our head tag. And let's also copy the font family part, and I will paste it inside our body tag, so that every element of our card will inherit the font family from our body. So now you can see we got Poppins font in all of our elements. And now let's continue styling our card body elements. So next we will style our name. So I will target the H2 inside card body, and I will give it a text transform of uppercase and a font size of 24 pixel. And that's it for our name. Now let's style the username. So I will target the username inside card body, and I just want to change its color. So I will give it a color of 9E. And now what I want is I want to center all of my text. Okay, so what I will do is basically I will give text align center to my card body, and now you can see all of our text is in center. Or you can do one more thing, that you can remove text align center from card body and also from card header, and you can only give text align center to card element, because card header and card body are child of our card element. That is why text align center will center the elements of our card header and card body. And now you can see all elements are in center. Now let's start styling our social media list. So I will target social media list, that is inside our card body, And first of all, I want to give social media list some spacing from top and bottom. So you can see we want some spacing from top and bottom of our social media list element. So I will give it a margin, and I want the margin to be 25 pixels from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. And now you can see we got some spacing from top and bottom. And I will also give display flex to our social media list, since I want the anchor tag inside our social media list to be in one row. Okay. And now I want to align them in center. So I will use justify content center. And now you can see they are in center. Now let's start styling our anchor tag inside our social media list. So we will now style our social media links. Okay. So I will target them. So I want the anchor tags inside social media list. And first of all, I will change its color to 565656. And I want its font size to be 30 pixel. So you can see we gave some stylings to our social media links. Now I want to give some spacing to the right side of our social media links. So I will give margin right to all of my anchor elements except the last one, because there is no other element on the right side of it. So we don't want any extra margin right on our last child. Okay, so I will select all the anchor tags inside social media list, but not the last child. So this selector will basically select all the anchor tags, but not the last child. So we are selecting these anchor tags only and not the last one. So I will give margin right to them, and I want the margin right to be 28 pixel. So you can see we got some spacing from the right side of our social media links. Now we also want to add a hover effect on them. So you can see when we are hovering on our social media links, their color is changing. So let's quickly add this hover effect. So I will target the anchor tag in hover state, and I want to change their color to 61A1DD. So you can see when I will hover on them, their color is changing. Let's also add transition property to our anchor tag. So I will write transition, and we are changing the color property. So I will write color here, and I want the transition duration to be 0.3 seconds. And now you can see we got a smooth transition when we will hover on our social media links. And we have completed the styling of our social media links. Now let's style the about text. Okay, so I just want to give it a margin bottom because we want some spacing from the bottom of it. So I will just give it margin bottom. So I will target my about element that is inside card body, and I will give it a margin bottom of 45 pixels. So you can see we got some spacing from bottom of it. And now the last thing left is the button element. So let's quickly style our button element. So I will target the button element that is inside our card body. And first of all, I will remove the underline. So I will give text decoration none to it. And also let's add a border to it so you can see it properly. So I will give it a border of 2 pixels solid and red in color. So now you can see our button element. So I want to give some spacing inside it. So I will use padding. So I will write padding property, and I want the padding to be 16 pixels from top and bottom and 48 pixels from left and right. So you can see we got some spacing inside our button element. And now I want to give our button element the same linear gradient that we had given to our card header. So I will copy the linear gradient from here, and I will paste it inside our button element. And also let's change its color and give it a border radius of 100 pixels. And now you can see our button element is looking nice. let's also give it a text transform of capitalize and remove the border. And now you can see our button element is looking great. Now I want to give padding bottom to our card element. So let's give it a padding bottom of 20 pixels. And now you can see our card is looking nice. Let's also give a box shadow to our card element. And I will write box shadow property. I want the X offset to be 0. I want the Y offset to be 20 pixels. I want the blur value to be 30 pixels. And for the color, as always, I will use RGBA format. And I will pass the RGB value for black, that is 0, 0, 0. And for the alpha value, I had passed 0.2. And you can see we got some nice box shadow on our card element. Now the only thing left in our card is this hover effect. Okay, so we just want to add a little hover effect on our button element. So let's target our button element in hover state. And I just want to make it opacity 0.8. And let's also add transition property to our button. And we are changing the opacity property. So I will write opacity here and I want the transition duration to be 0.3 seconds. And now you can see we got a little hover effect on our button and it is looking nice. So this was it guys. Look how easily we created this awesome profile card using HTML and CSS. And I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and understood every step. But still, if you have any doubts related to any step, just feel free to comment your doubts below. Also, I had planned many awesome tutorials for the next month, so make sure to hit that subscribe button because I'm going to level up your skills. Also, don't forget to check out about Newton School. The link to their website is in description, and I will see you guys in the next video.